Again, what I'm going to start with, I'm going to start with the next topic. In the previous session, it was the Python data type was there. In the data type, the important thing was there, like list. What is the property of the list? Number one, it's a generic. Number two, it's a dynamic. You can put n number of values over there. Third thing, it's a mutable. We can make changes over there. That's the good thing about the list. And for the list, what we need to use? We just need to use this parenthesis over there. If we are just mentioning anything in this parenthesis, it's a list. Other than the list, it was the tuple was there. Everything is just like your list. It's a generic, it's a dynamic, but one important thing is there, it's a non-mutable. Yeah, it's a non-mutable. We can't make the changes with that. Other than the tuple, it was the set was there. It was a string was there. In the tuple, what we need to use? We just need to use this parenthesis. Other than the tuple, it was like a string was there. A string is just the collection of characters. And with the list, with the tuple, with the string, we can get the value from the index. Like it will always start from the index 0. A string is there. We can declare the string within this. We can declare the string within this. We can declare the string within this. We can also declare the string within this. So these are the different options we are having for the string. Other than this, it was the set was there. The good thing about the set is, like, again, it's a non-mutable. The second thing, it's always contain the unique values. And it's an ordered sequence of item. An ordered sequence of item. It maintains the order internally. Like list is what? It's a ordered sequence. Tuple is ordered sequence. It's an ordered sequence. Other than the set, it was dictionary was there. In the dictionary, what we need to do? In the dictionary, what we need to do? Just we need to use the key and value over there. Key and value. So these things were there in the previous session. List, set, tuple. Again, to get the value, what we can do, we can use the negative indexing over there, like -1, -2, that we can apply with the list and all. Other than this, in the earlier session, it was how to print the things, how to apply the input, how to get the type, how to use, we don't need to declare the variables and all. And again, the thing was that how to use the indentation. Like if we are using the for loop, we always need to use the indentation over there. When we apply the for loop, the range function is there. By default, the range function will start from the 0 to 4. If I'm going to use the range like this, 1, 5 means it's 1 to 4. If I'm going to use the range function like this, range 5, 50. And we are giving the step over there. Like initially it will be 5. After the 5, the next value will be 10. After that it will be the 15. Up to 50 it will go over there. This 5 is what? It's a step. So these are the basic things in the Python. Now today what I'm going to start with, I'm going to start with the methods. The function I'm talking about. How to apply the functions over there. Then we are going to start with the operators. What are the operators over there? So, and again, we will go with the import, how we can import the functions and all. So this is the agenda for the today. And after that, we will go with some programs over there, that programs you need to write. And again, our focus will be on how to build the logic building. So, but initially we are just going to start with the methods, functions, operators, and after that we will go with the programs and all. So this is how we are going to start with the programs. File, new file, and here I'm going to write the program. So basically, see, in any programming language, we are having the concept of function. Like in C, or it's in Java, or it's in C++, or it's in C#. The same thing. In Python, we are having the concept of function. Like in, if I need to define the function in Java, how we can do that? Normally, we use void display. This is how we normally use the functions in Java. Like it's not going to return any values over there. And the same thing, if I need to define with the Python, how we can do this. So I'm just going to use the function. This is the comment line that we need to use. To define the function, we just need to use the keyword def over there. Def means define. And what we are going to define, we are just going to define the display. And naturally, we need to provide the body for that. So I'm just going to give the body. Print, thanks, and welcome in Python third session. So this is what, this is your function. Now what you need to do, this is the body of the function. You need to call the function. And to call the function, what we need to do? Oh, don't use this. To call the function, what we need to do, just I'm going to use display over there. I'm just going to give the name of the function, it will get called. Okay, can you tell me why we use the function? What is the use of this? In any programming language, normally we use function. What is the use of this function? Yes, please. Any answer from your side? Why we use function? Like in Java, its function is there. In C and C++, again the function is there. In Python, it's again the function is there. What is the use of the function?
To perform particular tasks or something. Like if
it's okay.
Do something. Yeah, like the functionality, like if we need to add something or display something or different kind of tasks.
Okay, let me define. See, there is a concept of subprogramming. What exactly is that? Subprogramming means what? How to arrange the big program into the smaller one. Suppose in a single program, I need to perform the add operation. I need to perform the subtract operation. I need to perform the divide operation. I need to perform the multiply operation that I need to do in the single program. In a single program, I need to perform the addition, subtraction, division, and multiplication. Naturally, if we don't have the concept of function, how we can proceed for that? There will be the main method, public static void main. Suppose I'm taking the example of Java. There will be the main method. Within the main method, what you need to do, you need to write the code for the add. After that, you need to write the code for the subtract. After that, you need to write the code for the divide. After that, you need to write the code for the multiplication. Suppose, again, I need to perform the addition. Again, I need to repeat the code. So, more or less, your program is a complex one. Like, it's a complex kind of programs. It looks like it's a complex one. So, what I need to do, we need to simplify these programs. How we can simplify the program? So, what we can do, just we can apply the subprogramming concept over there. Subprogramming means what? Arranging the program into a smaller piece of code. A smaller piece of code means what? Like these are the code for the addition. So what I will do, I will just make the function for add. And what I will do over there, I will just put this particular code in the addition. The same thing. Suppose I need to divide, I need to make the function for the subtraction. Okay, I'm going to make the function for the subtraction. And these portions, I'm going to use over there. So by the use of subprogramming, what we can do, we can get the modular approach of the programming. Now this is the different module we are having. This is the different module. According to requirement, what we can do? According to requirement, we can make it like we can call this. According to requirement, we can call this. Again, I need to perform this. Again, I can call this. So by the use of function, what we can do? We can achieve the modular programming approach. Modular programming means what? The subprogramming concepts I'm talking about. Program means what? It's a main program. Subprogramming is what? Different parts of programs are there. And that different part can get called from the main and all. So subprogramming is basically arranging the program into a smaller piece of code. And this is basically used for the modular approach of the programming. Modular approach means what? Modular approach means you are just arranging your code into the different modules. You are just arranging your code in the different module. Like this is the module we are having. Suppose again I need to, so this is how we can use the function. Like in Java, I need to use the void display. In the place of void, we are just writing def display. So this is the function, and this is how we can call the function. I'm just going to run this F5. Source must be saved. Okay, I'm going to give the name over there. And we are getting the message, thanks and welcome in Python third session. So this is the first function we are having. Okay, again, I'm going to use the function over there, def display one, and I'm going to pass the parameter. I'm writing print. We are just passing the parameters over there. I'm writing thanks and welcome in Python third session to Mr. Sys. I'm just using comma. I'm just using the NM over there. So this NM is what? It's a parameter. And I need to pass the value for that parameter. I'm just giving the display one, and I am passing the parameters for that. Like I'm going to give Santos. Run this. And we are getting the value. Thanks and welcome to Python third session to Mr. Ms. and Santos. So this is how we can use the parameters over there. Suppose, again, I need to call this function. No problem. Again, I'm going to call this display one, and I'm going to pass the parameter over there. Suppose the parameter I'm going to give like Smith. Run this. So we are getting the output like this. So this is how we can pass the parameter. This is how we can pass the parameter. So both the function, it's a different function is there. As such, there is no any parameter. In this function, we are having the parameters. Suppose, again, I'm going to use def sum. I'm going to create the function by the name of sum. And I'm going to give the parameter x, y. Now, what I need to do, I'm just going to use return x plus y. Means what? This function is going to return the value. Naturally, I need to call this function. At the time of calling, I'm going to use some variables over there. T is equal to, and I'm just writing sum of 33 and 44. This 33 will get assigned to the x, and this 44 will get assigned to the y. And finally, we are using return x plus y. So it will return like 33 and 44, the whatever the value will be there, it will get returned to the t. And what I need to do now, I just need to display the t. So I'm just going to use print. The sum is, comma, t. And we are getting the sum is 77. Now you can ask me like, if I'm looking for the user input, then how we can do this? Okay. Use the user input over there. N is equal to int. Input. Enter number. Again, I'm going to use M is equal to enter number, and in the place of 33 and all, I'm just giving T is equal to sum of N comma M. We are just passing the parameter, and finally we will get the sum of that. Run this. Enter number 66, enter number 77, and we are getting the output. The sum is 143. So what I'm trying to say, this is how you can return the value. This is how you can return the value. For the return, you don't need to define anything. Just need to use the keyword return. That's it. For the parameters, you don't need to define the data type. Just we need to pass the parameters like x, y we are giving. And this is how we are passing the values. So these are the different functions that we are using over here. Suppose, again, I'm going to give the function like def. I'm going to give like display 3. And here I'm going to use like x comma y. Again, this parameter is there. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to display print x is equal to comma space, and again finally we are using y is equal to I'm just going to display the x, again I'm going to display the y. Now what I need to do, I just need to call this function. How we can call the function? I'm just going to call this display 3, and I am passing the parameter 44 and 55. The 44 will get assigned to the x and 55 will get assigned to the y, so you will get the answer like, we are getting x is equal to 44 and y is equal to 55. But I want to make it change. Like, I want to pass this value for the y and this value for the x. So how we can do this? So what we can do, see, here we are using positional parameters. This is called positional argument. According to position, it's going to take the value. Like 44, this is the first parameter arguments over there. And again, we are giving 55. This will assign to the y. In the place of positional argument, what we can do, we can also use like this. Display 3, I am giving y is equal to 555, x is equal to like this. This is called named argument. You are just giving the name over there. If I am going to run this, again execute this, I'm writing enter number. See, we are getting x is equal to 822 and y is equal to 555. And we are getting x is equal to 822. So by the name you can also give the parameters value like this. Again, we are giving like, this is the positional argument. Positional argument, what? The value from the first position will get assigned to the first parameters. The value from the second position will get assigned to the second parameters. So this is how we can use the positional argument. This is how we can use the named argument. Again, suppose I'm going to use def display 4 and I'm going to use x is equal to 9 comma y, print, I'm just writing sum is equal to, I'm just using y is equal to z is equal to x plus y, and finally I'm printing print z is equal to comma z. Now I'm going to call this function display 4. So I'm writing display 4 and I'm going to give the parameters over there like 1 comma 2. I'm just giving 1 and 2. Automatically the x will get assigned to the 1 and y will get assigned to the 2. So the value what we'll get, it's a 3. Oh, sorry. When we pass the default argument must be in the last. Run this. See, we are getting z is equal to 3. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm just giving display 4. And I'm just passing the single parameters over there. Even though there is the two parameters, I'm not going to give the value for the y. So automatically the y will get assigned 8 over there. And so the result will be 55 plus 8 is equal to that the result you will get. This is the concept of default arguments. Default argument means what? If I'm not going to pass the value, if I'm not going to pass the value, by default this particular value will get assigned. Suppose I'm going to give, this is called default argument. By default, this value will get a sign over there. By default, this value will get a sign over there. We can also do one thing, like I'm going to make the function. Suppose I'm using display 5. I'm using x is equal to 3 and y is equal to 8. Now, if I'm going to call this, I'm calling display 5. I'm not going to give any parameters. It will work for you. Suppose I'm going to give display 5 and I'm just going to pass one parameter. It's fine. Again, it will work. This parameter's value will get assigned to the x, but y will be its default 8. Suppose I'm going to give display 5 and I'm going to give two value over there. Again, it will work. So this display 5, I can call like this. Run this. See what value we are getting. 77. Here what value we are getting? 563. 555 plus 8. Here what we are getting? 11. So what I'm trying to say, these are the different functions that we can use. These are the different functions that we can use. Suppose I'm going to give. So this is the concept of default arguments. This is the concept of positional argument. This is the concept of named argument. Now, one important thing that we can use, arbitrary argument. Arbitrary argument means what? I'm just going to use def display 6 and I'm going to use star z. I'm just going to use star z. Now we are using for I in range 1 comma z dot length. And I'm just going to display print z of I. This is your display 6. I'm going to call this. Just I'm going to make comment to all. I'm just calling the arbitrary argument. Display 6 and I am passing the parameter. I am passing the parameters over there. Now run this. Just wait. For I in range, I'm going to use from 1 to len of z. Now I'm going to display print z of I. Run this. For I in range. See, we are getting all these values 44, 55, 66, 77. We are not getting 33 because always it gets start from 0. Run this. We are getting all these values. So by the way, this is called arbitrary argument. Arbitrary argument means what? You can put n number of values over there. We can pass n number of values over there. That is called arbitrary argument. I'm just writing for I in range, it will get start from the 0 up to what? The length of Z. And finally, we are displaying the value and all. Suppose I'm going to give like display 6 and I'm going to give like this value over there. Run this. We are getting all these values. So this is the advantage in Python that you can pass the arbitrary argument. Arbitrary argument means what? Can put n number of values of any data types. So this is how we can use the arbitrary argument. So for the arbitrary argument, what we need to use? Just we need to use a star over there. Just like pointer, n number of values you can put over there. This is your default argument. One important thing that you need to remember, the default argument must be in the last. Like if I'm going to give x is equal to 8 and I'm not going to give this value. See what error message we are getting. Non-default argument follow the default argument. That we need to take care. Initially, it will be the non-default argument. After that, it will be the default argument. That we need to check. So these are the different types of functions over there. Here we are not using any parameters. We are not going to return anything. Here we are using the parameters. Here we are using two different parameters and again we are going to return the value. Here what we are using, we are just using the default arguments. Here we are using the arbitrary argument. This is how we can call the function. We are just calling this. We are just calling this default 6. I'm just going to make it uncomment. These are the different way to call the methods. This is how we can go for the user input and all. If we are passing the value like this, by default, it will be the positional argument. If we are passing the value like this, it's a named argument. You are using the name over there. Interesting thing, one important thing, like I need to mention over there. Like in Python, like in every language, there is the concept of method overloading. In every language, we are having the concept of method overloading. What exactly the overloading is? Overloading means what? The method having the same name but different parameters. Different parameters. Different parameters means what? Types of parameters. Types of parameter. Parameter. Or number of parameters. This is what? This is the definition of the method overloading. Method overloading means what? The function having the same name with the different parameters. Different parameters means whether it's a types of parameters will be different or the number of parameters will be different. How we can implement this concept in the Python? How we can apply this concept in the Python? In Python, what we need to do for this? It's really interesting. In Python, by the use of single function, you can apply the method overloading. In Python, by the use of single function, you can apply the concept of method overloading. See, this is your display 5. For this display 5, this is how you are calling this. Here you are not going to give any parameters. Here you are going to give one parameters. Here we are passing the two parameters. So this is how we can apply by the use of single method. we can apply the concept of method overloading in Python. That's really interesting. Like in Java, in C++, in C sharp, what we need to do, we just need to write the different methods over there. But in the Python, because we are having the concept of default argument, so this is how we can, even the display 5, we are calling the display 5 in three different way. So this is the good thing that you need to remember in Python. Like in Python, to apply the method overloading, by the use of single function, we can apply the method overloading. It's clear? Any questions from your side regarding this function?
Yeah, I know I had to practice that one, but no questions.
So everything is fine. Now we can move with the next.
Yeah, okay. I'm fine.
Okay, that's good. That's good. Okay, and now I'm just going to save this entire content in the particular file. Mm-hmm. Here I'm just going to paste that. Now, the next important thing is how we can use the import. How we can use the import. Import means what? Like we are having the function. The function is defining the different files. And that function I need to call in this particular program. Like in Java, we are having the package and all. Mm-hmm. In the package, you just put the classes and methods and all. In the different programs, you can call the package. The same thing I want to implement over there. How we can do that? For that, we just need to use the import over there. So I'm just going to define the methods. This is the method we are having, suppose. These are the methods we are having. Now what I need to do, I just need to call this method in some other program. So first of all, I'm just going to save this file. Save as, I'm going to give the name like a.py. Now what I need to do, I just need to call this methods in some another program. So I'm just going to use file, new file. Here I just need to use import a dot display one. This is how we can apply the import. Run this and we are getting the output. Like in Java, lot of things we need to do over there, but in Python you don't need to do lot of things. You just need to define the methods in a single file. Like every method will be there. You just need to apply the import. Need to give the name of the file. A is what? It's the name of the file. The file name is a.py, Python file. Just we need to apply the import, and finally we need to call like this. So it's really easy in Python how to apply the import. This is how we can apply the import. This is your file. It's a.py file is there. In this file, these are the functions. And what I need to do, I just need to call this. In the another program, I'm just going to use like this. It's another program is there. In this another program, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to write import a.display. So this is how we can apply the import over there. Now, after this import, now we are having the concept of operator. More or less you are familiar with the operators like plus, minus, multiplication, division. You all are familiar with all those operators and all. Like I'm going to use print. 5 divided by 2, it's 2.5. If I'm going to use print 5 double divided by 2, we will get the 2. Suppose I'm going to use 5 modulus 2, percentile 2, you will get the remainder over there. So these are the normal operators, like we can apply the greater than, less than, that's fine. Some special operators are there that we need to take care. Like we are having the concept of membership operator. Membership operator. in the membership operator, what we are having in, not in. Suppose I'm going to use m is equal to, and I'm going to create the list. Now what I need to check, whether that particular value is available or not. I'm going to use print 66 in m, and we are getting false. This value is not available over there. Suppose I'm going to use print 66 not in m. Is it true? It's not there. I'm just going to use print 33 in m. So we can use in or not in. This is what, this is your membership operator. By the use of this in not in operator, what we can do, we can find out whether this particular value is exist, is available over there or not. Other than this membership operator, we are having the identity operator. In the identity operator, we are having the is, not is. Like I am going to use identity operator, a is equal to 20, b is equal to 20. I am writing print a is b. We are getting true. Yeah, a is b. Like both having the same value. If I am going to use a is not b, is not b, we are getting false. So this is what, this is your identity operator. This is